Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learning Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1700. 26 by 26 letters, no repeats both ways. All right, well, it feels like this has been going on all week. Oh, it has been going on all week. Kris is actually looking for a 26 by 26 grid where there's no repeats going across the row, but no repeats going down the column. All right, so first thought, let's just do brute force and see if it works out. All right, so here's our 26 by 26. We generated this yesterday using the random no repeats. And I added some conditional formatting in, Alt-O-D, formula that says, hey, we're going to count everything above us, so B1 to B1, this was actually written right up here, B1 to B1, see if it's equal to B2. If that's greater than 0, then we highlight it in yellow. So all of the duplicates are being highlighted in yellow. Let's see how bad the situation is. Hey, I actually learned something from Mike Gervin's formulas. So we look at the max. This is a wrapper function. We're going to count everything from B1 to B26 and see if it's equal to each of the 26 letters. So the mid of that string, row 1 to 26, when we use Control-Shift-Enter, that coerces that into an array of 26 values, and the mid gladly returns all 26 values to the COUNTIF. COUNTIF returns 26 values, MAX counts them up, Control-Shift-Enter. And so here, there the most, there's one letter at least that's repeated three times. So the S, and the S right there. So we have S appearing three times. And what I thought I could do is just kind of do a little max out here, keep pressing F9 repeatedly until I finally get this max to be zero, then everything has just worked out. But before I sit here and start pressing F9 for the next 432 years, let's see if this is even possible. All right, so let's do some basic statistics. How to build a row. First letter, we have 26 choices. And then the second letter, we have the remaining 25 choices because we can't repeat in the row. And then 24 and 23, 22 all the way. So we have to multiply 26 times 25. And there is an Excel formula to do that very thing. It is called fact, which does a factorial. Fact of 26, and that's scientific notation. Let's convert it back to a regular old number with commas, that way we can count. All right, wow, there's a lot. So there's millions, billions, trillions, quadrillions, quintillions, I don't even know, a big number of possibilities. This certainly is going to be possible, you would think. All right, here's my math of why I think this can't be done. A 26 by 26 grid has 676 cells. As soon as I go to row 1, column 1, and I choose a letter, I don't care what letter, the letter F, I've just eliminated all of the rows that have an F in column 1. All right, so there were 26 unique letters that were in column 1. I just eliminated the F. That's 126. That means I have 25, 26 left. So though, although I had 403 septillion before I started this, I'm now down to 387 septillion. And then when I place the second letter, I'm down to 372 septillion. Third letter, and so on. By the time I get down to the bottom of the first row, all right, I placed all 26 letters, I'm down from 403 septillion to 145 septillion. Still sounds like a really big number, right? But it keeps getting smaller and smaller and smaller. And according to my math, and I'm not sure my math is right, somewhere down around 24, row 24, we run out. There's going to be no possible combinations left. It just isn't going to work. Here, I have a chart here. Let me scroll over. All right, so we started with 403. That was before row 1. You know, by the time we get down to row 10, I think we're down to 3.7 sextillion. And then down around row 20, we're down to only 32 trillion. It still sounds like a lot, but very quickly, it just goes away. According to my math, there's no way this will ever work. But hey, bad news, my math has to be wrong because Kris sent me a 26 by 26 that was created manually. So something clearly is wrong here. There must be a solution to this. Okay, so at the beginning of this podcast, I just tried the random 26 by 26, and that didn't work. Let's see if we can get better than that. So here I have almost a million different unique combinations, not 407 septillion, because we only have a million rows in Excel. But I randomly selected one of these and said, all right, that's going to be our row one. And then I wrote a macro that went through and said, we're going to come back here, we're going to turn on the filter, data, filter, and for our first letter, we're going to turn off the Z. So open this filter drop down, turn off the Z, and click OK. And down at the bottom, it'll tell us that, you know, we've lost some small percentage of the records. And then for column 2, I go and I turn off the filter for Y and go all the way through. And after doing all of that, we were down from 955,000 to 366,000. We lost about 64% of the possible rows. And then of those that were left, out of these 366, I just randomly chose this. And now I had to go back through, and of course, at this point, the macro is doing it. And in column 1, turning off the Z and the U. Column 2, turning off the Y and the K. And we're down already very quickly to only 43 or 129,000 rows that'll still match. Randomly chose one of those. Change the filter now to turn off all three letters in each column, 43,696. And sure enough, after row 11, I'm down to, that was it. There was only five left after row 10. I chose one of those five, and I had wasted all my chances. Now, I only had a million rows in Excel instead of 407 septillion rows in Excel, so I ran out a lot sooner than my math said I would have run out. But even if we go to Power Pivot, we're never going to get 407 septillion million rows. This method just is not going to work. Now, good news, there is a solution. Tomorrow, we'll show a completely different way to attack this problem. Well, hey, I want to thank Kris for sending this question in. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.